Gun violence was in the spotlight again recently when Minnesota's attorney general decided to sue a local retailer. He said the company should have known a customer was buying firearms for someone else. So how is a gun retailer supposed to stop straw purchases, and what are the red flags? Good question. Here's Jeff Wagner.
Straw purchasing is when someone buys a gun for another person who isn't legally allowed to own one, such as felons. Two Minnesotans were recently charged and convicted for committing the crime dozens of times. One of the guns was used in a deadly mass shooting last year in St. Paul.
It's definitely a concern.
Dave Bean is the owner of Get Guns Now, a licensed dealer in Oakwood.
I think we find it a moral obligation to try to, you know, reduce and ideally completely prevent, which is not, you know, really possible, but it's kind of our end goal.
It's not worth 10 years in jail.
There's even a campaign called Don't Lie for the Other Guy, reminding straw purchasers of the potential prison time and encouraging dealers to stop them. A survey of 1,600 gun dealers found more than two-thirds of them experienced a straw purchase attempt in the previous year. Of that group, 10% say it happened more than once a month.
That doesn't surprise you? Why not?
I would actually be surprised that the number's not higher. I probably turn away at least one a month.
When buying a gun, the customer fills out a form to pass a background check, which includes acknowledging they are the actual buyer.
But because they fill out that form, if a gun is traced back to them,
they're going to be in big trouble. Yeah, it's a felony offense to commit a straw purchase.
What are some of those red flags that you look out for?
Sure. So the big one is nervousness. Coming in with a picture that somebody texted them of a certain firearm saying they want that gun, and they don't really seem to know anything about that particular firearm.
Other red flags include a customer being on their phone with someone else during the purchase. Bean says he has to trust his instincts.
You just politely tell him that you're not comfortable selling that firearm to him.
Especially since the same background check form states, anyone who transfers a firearm to any person he or she knows or has reasonable cause to believe is prohibited from receiving or possessing a firearm violates the law, even if the seller has complied with the federal background check requirements.
I mean, we could get in a lot of trouble if we knowingly are facilitating straw purchases.
Jeff Wagner, WCCO 4 News.
If someone buys more than one gun or several guns within 5 days, dealers are required by law to notify the ATF. It helps agency track potential gun trafficking. If you have a good question for Jeff, just email him through WCCO.com/links.